On this podcast, I profile people who have left a mark on history, and all of them had one thing in common. They were all gay, lesbian, bisexual, or transgender. My name is Frank Howard, and welcome to Gay of the Day. When Truman Capote's novel, Other Voices, Other Rooms, was published in 1948, replete with a seductive and scandalous photo of the author on its dust jacket, Capote received an envelope from Paris. It was from a man he'd never met. Inside the envelope was a blank check and a one-word note. Come. Capote ripped up the check, which surely would have bounced anyway, and was on the next boat to France. For the man who was summoning him was a legend, a mythical figure, the lover of kings, princes, millionaires, and the gay intelligentsia. The world's most famous male prostitute, and today's gay of the day, Denham Fouts. When Capote arrived in Paris, he found an impotent, opium-addicted but still beautiful Fouts shuffling around a grand but sparse apartment. Fouts wished not to fuck but to talk, and talk he did. Spinning Capote yarns of his exploits so outrageous one begins to question their veracity, as if to perpetuate his own notoriety. After all, good PR and word of mouth was how he became an in-demand gigolo. With his gigolo days in the past, life was going on without him, and I suppose he wanted to sell his story to Capote for some cash. He had bills to pay and a habit to feed. What is known about Fouts is that he was born and reared in Jacksonville, Florida. By age 14, he worked in his father's bakery by day and prostituted himself at night, taking advantage of the wealthy tourists who breezed through town. When Fouts' father learned of his sexuality and what the lad was up to at night, he beat him mercilessly. Clearly, Denny Fouts needed to leave the family hearth. Luckily, one of the men whom Fouts was servicing was a German baron and a cosmetics tycoon. The smitten baron offered to whisk a 16-year-old Fouts to Berlin to be his lover. So Fouts left Jacksonville faster than you could say, "Lass uns ficken." Once in Europe, Fouts began to be passed around by millionaires and royalty. His reputation began to spread amongst the creme de la creme as one of the most attractive and exciting men on the planet, not to mention the best lay money could buy. He quickly became, quote, "the most expensive male prostitute in the world," end quote. That is Fouts' quote, by the way. In Germany, he became the lover of Nazi sympathizer Lord Evan Morgan, and one night found himself at the same dinner table as Adolf Hitler. According to Fouts, Hitler propositioned him over dinner. Fouts rebuffed his advances, telling Hitler that he couldn't afford to get into Denny's pants. This feels like a tall tale, but part of me wants it to be true. Capote later wrote, quote, "If Fouts had slept with Hitler, as Hitler wished, he could have saved the world from the Second World War," end quote. All right, we'll bye bye you.
went shopping, it was all COD. COD's the way you're gonna get love from me. Bye bye, for baby.
Fouts loved the attention and money, of course, but more than that, he actually loved his job. He loved to screw and be screwed. Supposedly, he performed his duties with such vigor and zeal that he would occasionally burst blood vessels. Some of his confirmed lovers were actor Jean Marais, King Paul of Greece, Prince Paul of Yugoslavia, the Shah of Iran, millionaire art dealer Peter Watson, who gifted Fouts a masterpiece by Picasso, singer Lena Horne, he pounded her pro bono, and Aristotle Onassis. After a few months of dating Onassis, Fouts became bored with the young Greek tycoon, and with the aid of a Greek sailor whom Fouts was seeing on the side, tied Onassis up and made off with bags of cash and jewels. The Onassis family, to avoid any embarrassment, never pursued criminal charges. He drank, did more drugs, smoked more cigarettes, drove faster, and fucked more than anyone. He'd often engage in life-threatening activities. He once walked the ledge of a hotel in Paris, shooting flaming arrows at pedestrians down below. He was impudent and unpredictable, and in the blink of an eye would go from aw shucks southern charm to fits of violent rage. He was an irresistible bad boy. Predictably, most who live fast die young. By the time Capote met him, he was all fucked out. Bedridden, his blood coursing with opium and bedsheets drawn up to his neck and staring out into space. Fouts' live-in boyfriend would often have to remove lit cigarettes from his mouth before they burned his lips. He died, of course. He was only 34. The official cause of death was a defective heart.
Schöner Schigolo, armer Schigolo, denke nicht mehr an die Zeiten.
His manner and looks didn't impress everyone. Gore Vidal once said that Fouts was, quote, good-looking in a cadaverous way, end quote. But nearly everybody he met, male or female, gay or straight, said that Fouts was the most magnetic and ludicrously attractive person they'd ever met. This allure doesn't come off in photographs. He's attractive, yes, but he looks more ordinary than you'd expect. I suppose you had to be in his presence to feel the pull. The mystery of irresistibility. Fouts, or characters based on him, appear in the works of Capote, George Plimpton, Gore Vidal, Paul Bowles, and Christopher Isherwood. There exists, in some people, what the French call je ne sais quoi, that special extra something, indefinable but present and palpable. Many parlay that electricity into performance. It is often said actors and musicians possess the it factor. But what happens when the bearer of such magnetism holds only a talent in the sack? I suppose the only thing to do is to allow it to run its course. And it would be truly wasteful to squander any gift. If one can paint, one should paint. If one is a singer, then sing. Denham Fouts was a talented fucker, and he left his mark doing just that. And at the end of the day, we all prostitute ourselves in one way or the other. Would that our self-sale always ended in orgasm. Today's gay, socialite, and king of the gigolos, Denham Fouts. Gay of the Day's theme is composed and performed by Swick, that's C-W-I-O-K. Check out their Bandcamp page. My name is Frank Howard. See you next time, and thanks for listening.